wind. It can cause widespread destruction over thousands of miles, strip the warmth from your skin, or bring relief on a hot summer day. But what forces are at play to cause particles in the air to move from one place to another? In the most basic sense, air flows from areas of high pressure to low pressure. It's the atmosphere's way of trying to balance things out, also known as diffusion.
Think about it this way. When you fill a container with air, like this balloon, high pressure builds inside. When you let the air flow freely, it rushes to the relatively lower pressure of the air around it. The same thing happens on massive scales in our atmosphere, driven mainly by differences in temperature.
For example, areas of high pressure typically follow a passing cold front, which is attached to an area of low pressure. The greater the pressure difference between the two, the stronger the wind, sometimes leading to intense gusts spanning hundreds, if not thousands, of miles. Thunderstorms form from a similar process, but on a smaller scale. As warm air rises through cooler, dense air, it forms what's known as an updraft. If the atmosphere is unstable, large differences in pressure or temperature exist, speeding up the updraft's winds. The air eventually condenses and cools, falling back towards the Earth's surface in the thunderstorm's downdraft. When the downdraft hits the ground, the wind rushes away from the storm, with gusts sometimes surpassing 100 miles per hour, causing serious damage to people and property. And it all comes down to differences of temperature and pressure. For WeatherNation, I'm meteorologist Rob Bradley.